Right, guys, I don't actually know where this video is going, to be honest with you. I just thought, you know, the floor's come for the garage and I'm going to put another one down. It's given me a new sort of sense of respect for the customer because I'm paying for it. And so, you know, choosing colours, everything and that lot. Once it's stuck on you and you're doing it for yourself, it's a lot difficult. But I knew the two colours. I had a picture in my head that I wanted to mix the two. And that is like Karndean's vangough and smoke toke and charred. Now, I mean, as a rule, when I've done custom work, the customers have chosen the colours and things like that. It's just progressed naturally. But I didn't know what style I wanted to do, but I knew I just wanted to get these two colours together because I just knew they would work, and they do, because obviously you've got your real dark parts of the charred and the, you know, the different fucking textures and that lot, but you're also picking out the smoke token it. So, depending on how you lay, I mean, I will go with plank selection, you know, making sure I get the darker sides, you know, to hit the, you know, don't have two like a dark smoke oak with a light charred oak, you know. These are sort of things you've got to consider now, but this area, I wanted to do a herringbone. I didn't know whether I'm going to cut it down or not. Because again, if you're doing custom work, that's another one you've got to decide, haven't you? You know, because if you're going to cut it down, you can't cut it down and then fuck up and then decide you don't want to. So you've got to try on the full plank. Van Gogh full plank's 48 inches. So it's not a herringbone friendly one, is it? So the headers are not going to, you know, the length does not divide equally by the width, but you know, that's not the issue here. I mean, here what I've got is I've got the two directions, the main dominant directions of the room or the area that you're going to start putting it in. TV, but that's not the centre of the room. And then you've got the patio doors, which is a very dominant one as well there. So I've sort of made my mind up, but I'm going to go with my two-direction herringbone, and that is, you just change the colour every fourth row, so you can lay the herringbone going that way, but you're going to give that zigzag going across, giving it the two directions. So it's a compromise, but even that, I mean, once I've got that, so I mean, I'll be pulling up in a minute anyway and starting the game. But what I've done, I pinned the chalk line centre of the TV going down, and I've pinned the chalk line, you can't see, but from centre of the patio, the doors coming up. So that is sort of like my cross section of where I wanted to start or where I wanted to go. Now, I've just got to the point now where I'm sort of like ready to go, and I've suddenly thought to myself, right, you know, coming from that central doorway and that, do I want the dark starting in the middle? So you're going to have the dark zigzag coming up and then how it falls either side, or do I shift this pattern up and at the centre of the third plank, middle plank here, coming from that centre and then having the two darker ones coming up? You see what I mean? You can't, it's never a case of just throwing planks on the floor. You see the end job when we do some of these things, but even every lad that's trying these little experiments, there is a fucking shitload of work that goes into it, but that you're never going to see and it never really gets appreciated, and that is the finding out, the figuring it out. So yeah, I mean, if you are going to start doing a little bit of custom work or something like that, basically you'll know if you can do it. I mean, if you start getting that bug and you want to do it, that's it, you know, you can do it. But you've just got to accept the fact that it is sometimes a lot of work that you're going to put into it that's never going to get seen or appreciated, you know. But, you know, it is something you're going to have to go involved in, especially if it's going to be with the customers, because, you know, you've got the pressure, the time, the money. So, yeah, so, I mean, it's different if you're doing border work or a custom like parquet one or anything like that. Like, it's different, isn't it? Because you know your pattern before you're doing the room. You've just got to get it set out right. That's the important part, you know. But after that, once you centralise that, it's just straight lay around the edges with the border. So, in theory, it's not, you know, I was thinking about bordering here, but I want to show the fitting around the walls, and it's, you know, straight lay. So, Yeah, I'll probably put the camera on time lapse or something, because I just haven't made my mind up, and I don't even guarantee that it's going to be this design at the end of it. This might trigger into something else, but it's sort of flicking the switch at the moment. But now it's going to be a case of shifting up and down, moving about, until you find those simple little things that everyone sort of like takes for granted, that if you don't plan it out, it's loads, you know? I mean, you've got to lay out so many areas to get that visual, then it's, you know, so much time. Yeah, I'd be lucky to get anything down on the floor today. But, so, as you can see, obviously the two directions there. Oh, I think I am going to go with the centre of this, so it looks like a lighter path coming up, and give me my two dark ones going either side, even if it throws into the wall or out. It's going to be that kind of pattern, isn't it? So that's a fucking light, you know, to shift that across there to get that centre there. Look at the point. The point's going to be through the wall. So you've got to find these ones. I don't know how I'm going to do that at the moment. We'll get there. But that's going to be the design anyway. It's going to be the charred oak and the smoke tape. I mean, vangough has always been my favourite plank anyway, but I like... I mean, look at the grains on these. I mean, they are... The richer colours are just so beautiful, aren't they? I mean, they can just... You can make a pattern with just like one style of floor, and just by, you know, choosing the planks. So I've even made a fish out of one of those ones there, using the actual grain in it as the fish scales. But yeah, so it really is, you know, those ones that are trying it, it's just to show a little bit, you know, appreciation for what they do, because... You know, you've got to really, really want to do the job to be able to, you know, come up with something like that. And when you do come up with it, share it with all the lads, because then, you know, this can be anyone who wants to do smoke, choke or charter. It's a visual for them to start seeing it on the floor, isn't it? It's a combination. And if you don't have these experiments, you know, the more we do, the more people are seeing. Anyone's more than welcome to use any of my ideas. I think it's the biggest compliment in the world when a fitter does it, you know? So, so this one's going to be a two-tone, hopefully. Because I was going to do like a Georgian square with it, you know, or then just with the straight cuts inside, but I want to try and do it with a minimum of cutting or something like that in the guillotine. It's not like a, to make your own parquet or make your own sort of design. So, you know, I like it when a number one looks at it, if it looks at it and goes, oh, fucking, I could do that, that's easy. Oh, but you never thought of it? It'd be a few hours, it's already been a few hours, and you know, I'm not getting anything stuck yet or anything like that lot, so you just got to take that into consideration if you want to do this sort of thing. The job satisfaction at the end is definitely fucking worth it, but you know, they're not all going to be winners. You can go through four or five different shit ones before you find a good one, but just, you know, if you don't try, you don't know, do you? So, enough waffling on. We'll get this started. Yeah, I've got to pull them all up again. There's a lot of that goes on with this sort of thing. And I'm going to keep it the full plank size, I reckon. So, full plank size, path coming up through. So, we'll put it on time lapse now.